I brought my tripod, so I'm gonna set this up so hopefully you guys can see me. Oh, this is good. And Paul Ravella, I was working his camp in Florida, and I mentioned to him, I was like, oh, I need to do, because I do my own show makeup and my own show hair for my competitions, and I just mentioned that I wanted to maybe do a demo or something. He was like, just set up your camera on show day and then just roll with it. I had my pump up in the morning and then my first meal, and then I will eat again in about an hour and a half. So I like to do my hair first, because then I don't have to like be brushing around my makeup once my makeup is done. You guys have a pretty good viewpoint here with my hair. My hair is pretty easy, so I have tape-in extensions and just a few strands of tape-in extensions to give me a little bit more length. My hair is pretty long and it's straight, so I just keep it straight, keep it simple. I don't like curling it, I don't like doing anything too crazy. So make sure when you're doing your show makeup that the counter is dry. So a lot of times the countertop can have just extra things on it and moisture, and you don't want that, because if you lean into the countertop, it will ruin your tan. And I got tanned last night. You usually get tanned the day before, or pretty much always if you're a girl. I don't know about guys, they do it differently. But, and then we get touch-ups today before the show starts at 10 a.m. It is currently 7:30, I believe. So I'm planning to, it'll probably take me about an hour to do my hair and makeup. So I'll be done at about 8:30. We're gonna head over about 9:20. And then I figure we're not going on until a bit later, but I just wanna be all ready to go. It's better to be ready early. I'm going to get my blow dryer. So you wanna make sure for hair and makeup, or for hair, that you have a good dry shampoo and a good hairspray. Spray, dry shampoo, some like oil, oil shine for my hair. So what I'm gonna do first is blow dry it just to get some of the kinks out. And I will plug in my straightener to warm up, and we will start rolling. So pretty simple, but you want hairspray and dry shampoo for some volume. I tease my hair just a little bit in the front. I won't do that until after I do my makeup, but I usually start preheating my iron. So here we go. So one thing I wanted to mention is that you want to make sure you dry, or you wash your hair right before you get tanned, the day before, or else, well, at least for those who have greasy hair, because my hair tends to be greasy, or you know, just oily, because I have a bit more oily of a scalp and skin, and that way your hair isn't oily. Like the next day, you don't have to use a ton of dry shampoo. I'm filming my hair. I got that on camera, me being scared to death. Just my mom. I'm easily scared when people come up on me fast. So I think one thing that people tend to think is that your hair and makeup for show day has to be like super complicated. But honestly, you don't want something on your head that's gonna detract from your physique. So simple is actually better. I remember there was a judge that was kinda, I mean, not that you should take everything that every single judge says literally, but you know, cause it's just one person's opinion. But he said that, you know, overly done makeup or like overly crazy shoes or overly crazy, you know, jewelry kind of, it detracts from your physique. You don't want the judges looking just at your earrings. Like, if they're, like, huge, you, or, you know, your hair is, like, whoa. You just want it simple so they look at your beauty and look at your, the package that you're bringing, not necessarily just one certain thing. Mom?
Yeah?
How was breakfast?
Same as yesterday. It was good.
I enjoyed just sitting.
I figured you would. I enjoyed. I read my Bible.
That's good. I read some. Well, you know what's been good? I download that. It's that Bible app.
Yeah.
It's called YouVersion. Yeah. It gives me daily Bible verses.
Oh, that's nice.
And then I usually just study those and read the chapter.
That's funny.
It gives you daily Bible verses, and then you can expand it and read the whole chapter or read the whole, like, section that it comes from. Oh. So I usually do that. Yeah. Well, today my thing was just, like, living for Christ, because if he wouldn't have died, if we were perfect, we wouldn't have need him to die for us, essentially. Like, so we need him. And just remembering that. Dry shampoo. Put a focus. Travel size. Just to get a little volume. Make sure it's not greasy by the roots. Alright guys, I got my camera set up in the background. That's what I'm gonna be filming. Makeup. Also, make sure you get enough of this out so you don't have, like, white roots. I love the dry shampoo that's, like, dark colored, but it's so huge that I couldn't take it on the... Well, I probably could have put it in my suitcase, but I didn't want it to, like, explode in my suitcase. So we are making do, but Batiste, that is the best dry shampoo that exists. They make one for dark hair, and so it's dark colored, so it doesn't make your roots look too light, because that's sometimes you have to be careful with that. If you don't have blonde hair, you use normal dry shampoo, because it's, like, white, and you don't want to have white roots that will look weird if you have brown hair. Maybe you is a brunette. Like, if you're a guy and you say, you send me a shirtless selfie, like, I'm just gonna delete it. Sorry. If you send me a Bible verse, though, I might answer you. So it goes down in the DMs. Alright, so first, primer. I use a mixture. It is Natural Radiance MAC Primer. Two pumps plus one pump of my Color Science Skin Balancing Primer, which is cocoa, as you can see, stark. Helps give me a little tint. I'm gonna do eyes first, then my face, because any powder I get from my eyes onto my face, I want to be able to wipe away. You don't want to do your face first, like your skin, your foundation. And I do not tan my face. I get dark makeup because if you tan your face, it tends to look really weird and muddy, so don't do it. Just get makeup to blend it. Alright. Eye primer. I'm just using Urban Decay eye primer.
Urban Decay.
Oh, that works. Well, Color Science. Skin Balancing. That's the one with cocoa. Eye primer, do a little below the eyes too. So first is eyeshadows. Do want to do, I'm going to take this brush. It is a C510 from Crown Pro. I got these from my friend who is a makeup artist, so I'm not exactly sure what these numbers mean, but it's kind of a flat, it's just a flat eyeshadow brush. I'm gonna take my sparkly, so this is my color palette. I'm gonna take this sparkly one and do this first. So really pat it in. So this will be the base sparkle color. And these are all MAC eyeshadows. And this color is Mythology. You really wanna pack it in there. Do it all over the lid. So this is the Mythology from MAC. Pack it in there, right up to the lash line. You want it to be bold. Stage makeup is meant to be bold. I like to blend this a little bit, just with the top, with a blending brush. Just a little bit. To make sure it's not harsh lines. I'm going to take my next color, just kind of this taupe. It's called HAUX Ho or Ho Ho Ha. As you can see, this kind of color. It's a matte color, HAUX. Take a brush and put this in the crease. You want to do this kind of on the outside third of your eyelid too. So this is just creating that depth. Starting to create the depth without a ton of darkness in your eye yet. So outer half of your eye, outer third. And I'm gonna blend it a little bit. Next, I'm gonna take a little bit of this highlight color. This is Brulee A37. So I'll give you guys the numbers of these. So these are all MAC. So the first one was Mythology A17. Second one was HAUX B37. And this one is Brulee A37. So the highlight up here. We will blend this more. Make the brows stand out. Take your blending brush. Blend that top color so you don't have quite as harsh of a line. I'm gonna add a little bit more of this second color, the darker color, to the top. Trying to get that. Before I add the darkest color, I'm going to add a little bit more of this sparkly color. Brush my brows. There we go. And I get my eyebrows tinted. That helps a lot. Helps them. And I also have just been blessed with really good brows. They grow in thick, so I don't have to do much in terms of brows. Next, we got the crease corner color. This is Deep Damson? AC6. This plum color. These are all MAC eyeshadows. Just blend it into that outer corner, and then you'll start going in towards the lash line. And I'd say probably the outer fourth corner. This really adds that depth to your eye. You want to make sure you're connecting it to your eyelashes too. Shout out to Nonia for helping teach me how to do this. Nona Short North, if you look her up on Instagram. She's awesome. She also does Skype consults to help teach you how to do makeup. But she just went over this with me, and she did one eye, and then I did the other eye. So that way I was feeling more confident doing this as we went over it in her salon. So then I can do it myself, because show makeup is expensive. It's like $125 usually per show. And it's kind of stressful because you have to rely on the timing of whoever is doing your makeup, and sometimes they're late or whatever, so I'd rather just do my own in my hotel room where it's warm and I'm not freezing and I'm not at the venue with everyone staring at me. Because everyone's just looking at each other like, what are you doing? What are you doing? Like, I'd rather just be here relaxing, listening to my Christian music. Next, sparkles. So Nona gave me these sparkles to use. I don't know where she got them. Oh. Ben Nye Sparkles, MD1 Opal, only $8. Ooh, sparkly! So it's just white shimmer. So what you do is you take your setting spray from MAC, so this is just MAC Prep and Prime setting spray. You spray your brush, because it's just sparkles, it's not a powder, so it's not gonna stick unless you put a little liquid on your brush. So I spray my brush, the same brush I used for the sparkly color, and then I just go in here and pat it into the sparkles. Like, take this, dump a little bit into the lid, really pack it in there, pack it into the brush in the inside corner. You don't want to brush this, you want to pat it. I don't want it on my face. I'll add more primer below my eyes after I wet this one. You don't want sparkles all over your face, obviously. I'm going to use a pointed brush for eyeliner that looks like this, and then I'm going to use a liquid liner. So it's MAC called Pro Longwear Fluid Line, and it's just black, so I just dip the brush in, and then I will start on the inside corner of my eye and then go to the top. And you don't want to keep patting it. You want to do nice controlled strokes. Then come out here to the corner and connect it in. So if you keep patting it, it's not going to be a smooth line. You want it to be a nice line. That's something that I struggled with, when I first started doing this, was doing too short of strokes, and I still do that sometimes. But if you do more of a smooth line, it'll look more fluid and more like a liquid liner as opposed to a pencil, which you kind of want that more smooth look. Yeah. Now I'm gonna do the wing. Just a little wing. And then you wanna connect the wing kind of on top. a little Q-tip. Make sure you keep Q-tips on you, because those can be helpful if you mess up your makeup. All you do is just put a little of this Prep and Prime Fix Spray. Do this. And this is a really good, like, if you mess up your eyeliner, no worries. Use this. Make that sharper line for the wing. Alright, foundation time. I'm gonna fill in the corners a little bit more with a highlight. So I have this, it's just a like a just a shiny pencil. Lord and Berry. 1153. Being dark out from underneath my eyes that may have bled down. Make sure if you get like dark colors on your light eye pencils to wipe it off. With white eyeliner on the bottom of my lid, my bottom lid. I'm kind of extending the whites down a little bit so it makes your eyes just brighter. And I do have eyelash extensions. Hopefully I got that footage. I don't know. If not, oh well. At least am I worried right now. Putting on my foundation, and I guess I'll tell you what guy that it, what color, N5A54 and Pro Longwear NC45. I don't know if it's even gonna save, so who knows. I'm just talking to no one. All right. Blend it into the hairline. Blend, 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 blend. And I blended those two colors because I'm not quite as dark as the second one I listed. I'm not quite as light as the first one I listed. Blend, blend, blend. You wanna start blending into the neck too. Don't want a weird white line. And in your ear. Blend, 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 blend. Then I got another show in 2 weeks. So dark. Whoops. Made a goof. It's okay. It's fixable. Just blend. Blend some more. Make a goof and just blend. And just blend. And just blend. Alright, this is really dark. So get the excess off like I just didn't do. Light strokes. This is dark. You want it darker on your face. And around your chin. Contour. Use it for your nose. A little goof down here. It's okay. Blend, blend, blend. Make a mistake. Blend, blend, blend. Make a mistake. Blend, blend, blend. Very. All right. next, I'm gonna do the setting. It says MAC Prep and Prime, just setting powder. It's just white, like, just translucent powder. Just to set the foundation. Since I'm done with the makeup part, or the liquid part, filling in my brows, and then the last thing I'll do is a bottom, just my lashes with some waterproof mascara. It's just bargain store Voluminous Waterproof by Feline Noir. The backside of a clean brush, and if you have any jewelry that you got makeup on, like a nose ring. And last but not least, blush. Just a little bit. Just a little bit. Perfection. Looking good.